And so thanks to ample amounts, tens of billions of dollars worth of government funding around the world, you can see the expected uptick in semiconductor manufacturing capacity starting to heat up again this year and into 2025.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Chipstock Investor. Today we're going to be talking about chip manufacturing equipment and packaging companies because we believe that we are in the midst of an AI supercycle.
Yeah, that's right. Check out the AI supercycle video and manual that we did earlier this year, your complete guide to the semiconductor manufacturing process. Also, make sure you hit the subscribe button below.
Subscribing is a free and easy way to support us here at Chipstock Investor. If you want to be more involved in the community, make sure you check out our Semi-Insider membership. It's a great value at $5 a month. Gets you all of our video notes, some published manuals, as well as access to our Discord community where we have live Q&A sessions once a month and a great community of investors.
Yeah. What's $5 a month these days? Pretty much nothing except for this. Check it out.
You may be getting used to seeing this chart from us talking about the market segments that we have and where we are in the cycles. We're going to focus today on that AI infrastructure market segment up at the top. It's a new market and we're currently in max growth mode.
And of course, why do we call the wafer manufacturing and chip packaging equipment companies that critical choke point in the industry, the gateway to all things AI and really all things electronic devices? You can see this group of businesses sitting right smack dab in the middle of our semiconductor industry flow. That's why it's a critical choke point. These are very, very powerful industrial technology businesses. Casey put this slide together illustrating the general process of manufacturing semiconductors. You can get more of an explanation on what these different segments are and the specific businesses, all of the publicly traded stocks that participate in each of these segments in that industry or video link to that right here. And we have an older video from early 2023 explaining some of the economics of semiconductor manufacturing. I talked a little bit in the video on YouTube about Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing, their new fabs they're building in Arizona, and how that will add very little to the global supply of semiconductors. However, advanced chip manufacturing, especially those going into AI, though a small percentage of overall semiconductor supply, contribute an outsized amount of semiconductor industry revenue overall.
If you would like to find out more about the semiconductor industry as a whole, semi.org is a wonderful resource for what's actually going on in the semiconductor manufacturing world. Semi.org tracks over 1,400 fabs worldwide, and we're going to show you some slides from their website. Great resource.
Now, these slides, we've superimposed some of the actual semiconductor manufacturer logos atop this slide from semi.org. This is key to understanding what's actually powering the AI supercycle right now. Governments around the world are funneling tens of billions of dollars into increasing semiconductor manufacturing capacity. In the United States, there are multiple projects going on. Intel expanding lots of its existing facilities, new ones popping up in Arizona, and the big fab project in Ohio. Texas Instruments, of course, building new fabs in Texas, as is Samsung expanding in Texas, Taiwan Semi in Arizona, Micron in Idaho and New York, then jumping over to Europe.
Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing featuring again in Europe, Infineon and ST Micro, Bosch, all European semiconductor manufacturers. Intel is also looking to expand in Germany as well as in Israel.
Both in the US and in Europe, you have the CHIPS Acts. Together, those two pieces of legislation have earmarked about $100 billion in US dollar terms going towards expanding semiconductor manufacturing. And the reason for that, countries in Asia, which account for most of the worldwide capacity in semiconductor manufacturing, governments in Asia have been doing this for years, propping up their semiconductor manufacturing industries.
A couple of months ago, we did some videos focusing on Japan's revitalization of manufacturing in the semiconductor industry, Rapidus as well, making some waves.
And of course, Toshiba and Rome Semiconductor, also big players in Japan. Kioxia making new memory chips with Western Digital. In South Korea, we have, of course, Samsung, SK Hynix, and then the big player, Taiwan. So again, TSMC, United Microelectronics, Micron also looking to expand. All of these companies getting ample amounts of funding from all of those governments. So over 1,400 fabs worldwide, but a record increase in new fabs opening in the next couple of years. Well over 100 brand new facilities just in the next 2 or 3 years span of time, according to semi.org. And all of this is in support of an industry that expects $1 trillion or more in end market chip spending. So those are customers that buy finished chips and package them up into a computing system or an electronic system of some sort. And again, semi.org shared this back in September of last year. You can see the steady expected increase in actual capacity. So not actual manufacturing of the semiconductor wafers that eventually get cut up into chips, but the capacity to manufacture those wafers expected to steadily rise. Where is most of that spending going to build out all of those new fabs and update existing fabs? Well, a lot of it is going towards 300 millimeter or 12 inch wafers, equipment used to make those large wafers. The reason being, a larger wafer, not only can you cut more chips out of a 300 millimeter wafer, but a lot of these AI chips are just bigger. So with lots of AI systems being built, a lot of companies making a pivot to these bigger 300 millimeter wafers and the equipment needed to build them.
You can see the difference in size of these wafers that Nick was just mentioning. The smallest is 150 millimeter or 6 inch. The middle one is 8 inch or 200 millimeters. And that largest one that we were just speaking about is 300 millimeters or 12 inches. Those wafers are then diced up into smaller chips. And that's why, obviously, a bigger wafer will produce more chips. Those chips are then packaged up and placed in devices that we use in our everyday life or in an AI data center.
Okay, one of the latest public updates from semi.org, going back to actual semiconductor manufacturing capacity, this chart released in June, you can see the dip in growth from 2022 to 2023. That, of course, corresponds with the bear market, including the bear market for the semiconductor industry itself. That corresponds to this chart we showed you at the outset of this video. See the last bottom for most semiconductor markets, with the exception of the new AI and accelerated compute market, bottoming either in late 2023 or early on this year. And so thanks to ample amounts, tens of billions of dollars worth of government funding around the world, you can see the expected uptick in semiconductor manufacturing capacity starting to heat up again this year and into 2025, ultimately culminating in brand new record amounts of spending on the equipment itself in 2025, 2026, and 2027. Folks, this could be a really epic run for the semiconductor manufacturing equipment providers. And who are they?
Well, what we call the Fab Five. Those are the largest semiconductor fab equipment companies, ASML being number one, Applied Materials, followed by Lam Research, Tokyo Electron, and KLA Corp. The reason we call these companies the Fab Five is around 70% of revenue goes to these five companies for wafer fab equipment. Nick, why don't we talk about how these companies have been performing in the last year?
Well, so far in 2024, they got off to a really hot start. And then most of these stock prices, with maybe the exception of Applied Materials here the last couple of months, have taken a breather the last few months. But all of this is in anticipation of a return to fab equipment spending, robust growth in fab equipment spending, starting the second half of 2024 and lasting through 2027. So really big run-ups in these stock prices already this year. However, you can see the cyclical nature of these businesses over time, pretty pronounced drawdowns during bear markets. We, of course, had the one that started in 2018, lasting through 2019 when the U.S.-China trade war got started, the brief blip at the beginning of the pandemic, and then the bear market in 2022 and 2023. See, a lot of growth picks up pace as fab equipment spending bottoms, but stock prices tend to continue rising through, especially, let's say, the first half or first two-thirds of the run-ups in fab equipment spending. So if we're entering a new super cycle driven by AI, these stock prices could continue to rise well through 2025 and maybe 2026. Let's talk about valuation though. And the most dramatic of the Fab Five, as far as valuation goes, being ASML Holding. Here's their price to free cash flow in blue on a trailing 12-month basis, and then in yellow, forward-looking price to free cash flow.
We have some charts from our friends at finchat.io. Lots of great analysis tools that you can use in your personal assessment of companies. Link below to a discount of 15% off. Check it out below. Nick, for ASML, on a trailing basis, the stock has been very expensive. But how about on a forward-looking basis?
Well, when looking at free cash flow, yes, still expensive. 63 times expected full year 2024 free cash flow. But you can see the valuation expected to rapidly improve, assuming stock price remains the same throughout this year, which it won't. You can still see expected rapid improvement in profitability as we exit the current downturn and head into the next growth cycle. On a price to earnings basis, things look slightly more reasonable for ASML. Again, you can see the big expected improvement in valuation when factoring for full year 2024 earnings per share.
So that's ASML. Let's talk about one of our favorites, Applied Materials. Price to free cash flow at 28.5, and on a forward basis, price to free cash flow around 28. In comparison to ASML, the valuation is cheaper, but you can see that there is not expected to be as much improvement.
There's two primary reasons why that is. First, Applied Materials is the big generalist, while ASML is the specialist in EUV lithography. And of course, high-end EUV, a big part of manufacturing the most advanced chips, including AI systems. So Applied Materials, not as focused a bet on that AI supercycle. In addition to that, Applied Materials fiscal year actually ends in October. So right as the next growth cycle is expected to begin kicking into high gear, Applied Materials fiscal year comes to a close. So if we extend our look out into fiscal 2025, which will include the final couple of months of 2024, perhaps Applied Materials valuation improvement begins to look a bit more dramatically better.
Number three on our Fab Five is Lam Research. And we have been adding this one to our portfolio so far this year. Price to earnings has been between 38, 39, but on a forward basis, price to earnings at 31. Nick, where do you see this one in this upcoming year?
But this is another generalist like Applied Materials, but Lam historically with an outsized focus on memory chip manufacturing. By the time you're watching this video, we're probably getting ready to have a Micron earnings update. That will be a big indicator for Lam Research's forward progress on profitability. Micron, Samsung, and SK Hynix all scrambling to crank out more high bandwidth memory, HBM3E for NVIDIA. We should get some great insight from Micron. We'll have a video out later this week that should be highly pertinent to Lam Research. Maybe this valuation is about to get a lot better than it looks in this chart.
Tokyo Electron is the largest in Japan for wafer fab manufacturing equipment, and it is also one of the largest companies in Japan. On a trailing basis, price to earnings was around 44, and on a forward-looking basis, at 35. Tokyo Electron is also expecting a big run in profitability. Now let's switch to KLA Corp, which is the biggest player in metrology.
Similar story here on a price to earnings basis. Big expected improvements in profit in calendar year 2024 for KLA. We recently did a video on the smaller metrology competitors to KLA Corp. We're going to circle back to this in just a moment because this could be one of the most exciting segments of wafer fab and chip packaging equipment when it comes to the AI supercycle. But Casey, for just a moment, let's ask the question, what are we buying right now in our portfolio? We just did our mid-year review of our top semiconductor picks and refreshed that list for the second half of the year. What are we looking at?
Yeah, three companies that we are personally adding to our portfolio: Lam Research, Excellus Technologies, which focuses on ion implantation, and then Air Test Systems, a silicon carbide burn-in system. We also hold Applied Materials and ASML, the two top biggest companies in the Fab Five. In the metrology segment, we also have a little bit of KLA. And in addition to KLA, we've also added a small cap company onto innovation to our portfolio.
Last video we did on that just a couple of weeks ago, check that out. Onto Innovation and its smaller peers, Nova and Camtech, have been on a hot run in the last year. The reason being, metrology and process diagnostic and control equipment act essentially as real-world equipment that helps with the testing and dialing in the manufacturing process for cutting-edge chip designs. So once a company designs, let's say, a new AI chip, they send it to their manufacturer, but that manufacturer has to figure out how to actually make the chip. That's where these companies like KLA and Onto Innovation come in. These valuations look expensive, but if you want to know why maybe they're not as expensive as they appear on the surface, check out that video from a couple weeks ago. And then another area we get plenty of questions about is the backend process. The wafer is finished, it gets cut up into chips. Casey, what are our bets on packaging equipment?
We own Applied Materials and Lam Research in the packaging equipment department. These two companies provide lots of packaging equipment. Tokyo Electron is another great play. Some other companies, BE Semi, Kulik and Safa, as well as ASMPT.
Of the specific chip packaging equipment companies, BE Semi, or simply Bessie, is the biggest by far. We get a lot of questions on Bessie. Stay tuned in the coming weeks for a deep dive into that business. We're probably long overdue to dive into that one.
Stay tuned for that Micron update coming after their earnings report, as well as a deep dive into BE Semi or Bessie. We'll have lots more coming your way as this AI supercycle heats up. Make sure you check out our Semiconductor Insider membership as well. That gets you access to a lot of cool stuff, and it's only $5 a month. Make sure you're subbed to the channel, and we will see you all again very soon at Chipstock Investor.